For some years, I've been moving in this direction. My record is clear. But I keep moving in this direction. Any number of times I've explored my wondering at the possibility that King was over-optimistic, that Gandhi was over-optimistic, that I was over-optimistic in understanding Jesus to expect that eventually many, most, the majority of us would be saved. Anytime I've discussed this on a graph, each point in time would indicate movement by me toward a reduced and then further reduced perception that any optimism they had was well-founded, and today is yet a further move in that direction. I find it depressing, but I don't find myself depressed. Sad, but not depressed. More deeply concerned than ever. More than ever, I think I'm finding the evidence to face my suspicion of recent years that never did Jesus indicate that many or most of us would be saved from what in his day was a deadly toxic culture, and today is hundreds, thousands, million times more toxic. Yes, he saw that we were all born in our Father's image. We were all born to be creatures of the heart, our Father's kingdom. But that many, all are called to that kingdom, few choose. In even the mildly toxic culture of his day, to go to that kingdom and to live there on this earth in this life. And it's infinitely less likely today. Our genes haven't changed, but our culture, oh, what a toxic stew. The equivalent of a liquor store of the head and flesh. In every room, on every foot of every street corner, on every inch of the internet, on every store rack. I don't recall ever having the feeling that I have today, because I don't think I had the evidence accumulated enough that King and Gandhi were wildly optimistic. Oh, and Tolstoy, I forgot to mention him. Maybe that's the most surprising of all. To me, that a man of such incredible intellect would have been so wrong. He seemed, in the book that created Gandhi, the kingdom of God is within you, to have such a profound hope that because the words of Jesus had traveled to so many billions, hundreds of millions in his day, I guess, that like a glass that appeared only to hold clear water, but in fact was a super saturated solution of salt, I think, that the right tap on the glass might cause it all to crystallize. That is, us all to move en masse to humanity. But I don't remember him discussing at all the massive forces arrayed against that happening. Someday maybe I'll have a chance to reread, but I don't think it's there. May have been in his mind, but had it been in his mind, I think he would have gone on at some length. And I don't know that I've thought of it with quite that clarity until now. The armada arrayed the psychological objects that we've created and impregnated ourselves with, the defense mechanisms, the denial, the institutions, all arrayed to be sure this doesn't happen. What do I make of what I'm sharing here? What do I suggest that you make of what I'm sharing here? I don't know. I don't know. I'm sharing it because I think it's an important analysis. I think it's important to be analyzed. I think it's important to be understood. Does it have to do with giving up? Does it have to do with stopping in the attempt? Does it have to do with certainty that King and Gandhi were overly optimistic and that Jesus never was optimistic? No, I don't suspect so. The analogy I've used before comes to me yet again. A medical doctor comes over the rise of a hill and sees hundreds of bodies strewn on the ground from a horrible plane crash, many of them still with some shred of life left. Does she turn around in despair? Does she curl into a fetal ball in despair? Does she give up on saving all of the hundreds? She sets about saving as many as she can. And if that winds up being one, it winds up being one. If it winds up being hundreds, it winds up being hundreds.